stuff. And associates in pediatric therapy, we're going to talk to our patient of the month today. I am very excited. You know, I think now more than ever, we all need heroes. And you're looking for someone who probably exemplifies courage, who has a zest for life, who inspires you. And we have that today with our patient of the month, who is Reed. His mom, Candace, is here. We have Caroline Scott. We also have Lauren Hirsch. And you're going to meet all of them today, but it's a very inspiring story, Associates in Pediatric Therapy. All right, the director of marketing is here, Caroline. Caroline, if you would, a little bit of an overview about what Associates in Pediatric Therapy, what they do.
Yeah, we offer speech, physical, and occupational therapy. We are located all over this area. We also have an audiologist on staff, which we do for all ages, and we have a learning center. So any special needs that really you can think of, we cover. And in Reed's case, he goes to our Louisville office. So like I said, we've got Lexington, Bullitt County, so we're really in that Kentuckiana area, including Lexington and Indiana. So we try to treat a lot of people in a lot of places. So.
And we like to champion our patient of the month, and very deserved. I was reading Reed's story, and Candace, first of all, congratulations. You have a really cool son. I was watching. He's full of energy.
He is.
But Reed has had a number of challenges, but he seems to just keep winning.
He does.
Tell me a little bit about Reed's story.
Well, he had Ewing sarcoma, which is a rare bone cancer, and had a tumor in his pelvis, and had all the treatment for that, including a surgery to remove it. So he had some mobility issues that we're trying to address right now. And a tumor in your nose. That's right. So mobility issues is really what we're trying to address right now. So he went from scooting to walking with a walker, and just last night he got up and started walking a few steps on his own. So we're just making progress left and right.
You know, he is one of those guys that just has this courageous heart, and he has this will. And he's just, put it this way, he's not going to lose this battle. He is winning this battle. It's obvious. And you said, I love this quote, you said, make you crazy and melt your heart in the blink of an eye.
That's right.
He does it all. That says it all. So tell me a little bit more about Reed. Reed, maybe you can tell me. Okay, so you like music a lot, right, Reed? Mm-hmm. Do you play with your brother, too? Yeah? What are some of Reed's hobbies, Candace? What does he like to do?
Oh, he loves Legos.
Okay.
Loves to make messes and sand and lots of tactile things. So he's big on doing things with his hands. He loves to build and loves to play with things. He's fast, even with a walker and needing some help. He's very fast, so he moves from one thing to the next faster than we can keep up with him a lot of times. So
you know,
he's superheroes, too, of course.
I love hearing that. Now, he's had some very aggressive chemotherapy. So with that being said, he's getting stronger and the future is bright, right?
Right, exactly.
I'm so glad to hear that. You know, it kind of makes my Easter here to hear a great story like yours, Reed. You're an incredible young man. Let's talk to a lady who knows him very well, Lauren Hirsch, who is his physical therapist. Lauren, initially you probably weren't Reed's favorite person, were you? Because you were challenging him, is that right?
Yeah, I think that would be accurate. When Reed first came to us, he... you know, obviously had just had this huge surgery when they also took out some nerves around his pelvis, which caused his legs to be really sensitive. So he was even for us to just touch his left leg was very difficult. He was in a big, real cumbersome brace that was hard to move around and I'm sure uncomfortable. So yeah, at first me trying to make him scoot around on the floor and move his leg around was not his favorite thing, but say now we have a blast, don't we, Reed?
Y'all have fun?
Lots of fun.
Yeah, we do.
Lauren, you said something that I thought was really interesting. You said he's now become my friend, and you said I've learned from him. Mm-hmm. What have you learned from Reed?
Just to, I mean, obviously to, not to sound cheesy, but, you know, never give up. And I think kids in general are just so resilient. I mean, they can go through anything. And, you know, here he is. He comes into therapy every day singing Bruno Mars. And
I love that.
Always ready to run around.
Imagine Dragons.
Oh, you like Imagine Dragons?
Imagine Dragons.
Yeah.
He's, yes, he knows a lot of good songs. And, you know, it just makes our little bad days seem so insignificant when you see everything he's been through and he's still rocking and rolling.
You know, I always think it's really nice when I hear people say, well, my hero or my heroine is my mom or my dad. And you're, I don't think this is far-fetched to say Reed is kind of your hero, isn't he, Candace?
Yep, he is. Mm-hmm. He is our hero. He's strongest boy I've ever known.
There you go. You know what?
My revenge.
And it was interesting. I came in to meet him, and he instantly, I was saying, Reed, I've been dying to meet you. I read your story, and it's really cool, and you sound like such a really cool little guy. And he wanted me to meet his brother.
Yeah.
And so, and his brother is a neat young man as well. Hopefully we can get him to slide on into the camera picture here. All right. Caroline, if you would. This is not an unusual story. It's an inspiring story, but this is the kind of work you do at Associates in Pediatric Therapy.
Exactly. This is just another example of how family-focused we are. That's our main focus. And if you can get a great therapist and a great family all on board, we call that the dream team. And that's kind of one of the goals we work towards. And like she said, the therapist may not always be the most popular person in the beginning.
Well, they're challenging.
But, yeah. But they always end up having this beautiful relationship, and that's what it's all about. So
we're taking a look at some film footage of some of these children going through therapy. And yes. Associates in Pediatric Therapy. Candace, what improvements have you seen in Reed since your partnership there?
Oh, my goodness. Such a difference all the way around. He goes to occupational therapy also. So we saw some delays definitely with as long as he was in treatment. And so we've been working on those self-care skills and fine motor skills and just have seen such an improvement there. So obviously the most pronounced is with his physical therapy and his mobility, but we've seen improvements all the way around.
I've heard he likes to throw out I love yous and big hugs.
He does.
I love hearing that.
He is such a sweet boy.
I love hearing that. Lauren, tell me now, where are we as far as Reed's progress, and what are the goals now? I know you're always trying to set the bar higher. Where are the goals now?
Right. So like I said, when he came in, we were scooting around at first, just trying to get any kind of mobility and independence for him that we could. He had already had a little walker that he was familiar with, so we started with that first because that offers, you know, more support. But, you know, his balance is getting really good. His right leg is super duper strong. And so we started recently working with some forearm crutches. And he just took off with those as well. And like she said, today he got up out of the chair out in the lobby and started walking to me with nothing. So he's doing awesome. There is a little bit of a leg length discrepancy from what was taken out. So we are probably going to have to modify some shoes and things to make him a little bit more even and stable. But, I mean, he's definitely on his way to walking with, you know, little to no assistance.
So. I love hearing that.
So, yeah, he's doing great.
You guys will be celebrating Easter together.
We will.
Yeah, I love hearing that. What's one of your favorite songs, Reed? Do you have a song that you really like singing? What's your favorite song to sing?
Which one?
Got a lot of them? It's okay.
Imagine Dragons.
Imagine Dragons, okay.
I just heard that this morning on the radio.
I like that as well. Caroline, what do you recommend for folks who would like to maybe make an appointment? Should they go to the website, give
Absolutely.
You all a call? How do they make this happen?
Either one, then go to our website, kidtherapy.org, or call that number, 633-1007, and we'll be there to help you.
Reed is a very inspiring story, and he is the Associates in Pediatric Therapy Patient of the Month. All right, coming up, there seems to be cameras everywhere nowadays.